mentioned Vegas. Are there other, or are there still areas of law where you have not committed certain types of causes that you have not heard from the practice of criminal defense?
I have rules, and here they are.
I do not represent people who are involved in ongoing, continuing criminal enterprises.
I will not be a consigliori for a crime organization.
I will represent a person who is accused of committing the most heinous crimes once. I will not represent that same person a second time. I will not represent somebody, of course, who asks me to put on a false defense or a lying defense, or who will himself seek to take the witness stand and lie. But there is no case, no matter how heinous or grievous, in which a person were charged with a crime that I wouldn't defend them. I've been asked the question over and over again, if Hitler were found in a Brazilian jungle and no other lawyer in the world would represent him, would I agree to represent him? Obviously, if the answer were because he couldn't get a lawyer to go free, obviously I'd want to see him tried. I'm more interested in seeing people tried than in my own personal comfort. The other case I want to take, and this just happened recently, I can't go into it, I won't take a case where somebody picks me to take it because I'm Jewish. I won't take a case because, and I have women friends who have the same view, they won't take a case if somebody picks them because they're a woman or because they're African American. I want to be selected to represent somebody because of what I can bring to a case, intellectually, academically, but not. And I also won't take a case if somebody says, well, I want you to take a case because you know the judge, or you know this, or you know that. That's just not the role I want to play. But other than that, I will defend anybody, no matter how heinous their crime is. I can't defend somebody who threatens my family or somebody, and I've had that happen on many occasions. Beyond anything personal recusals, in general, I think of myself as a priest. I don't think a good priest would turn down a sinner, no matter how much of a sinner they were. I believe very much in the system, and the system mandates that everybody have representation. And I can't say I'm bullying now. I can't take the position. Everybody should have a lawyer, but I'm too good for that. I mean, as a professor, I have to teach by example. And my example is, I'll take on every, look, cases are very difficult. I lost a lot of money and a lot of favorable attitudes when I did what my mother calls the OJ phase of my life. When I go to events now, people say, oh, I'm related to you, and they're close. When I was in the OJ case, even people named Dershowitz denied being related to me. Who knows? I mean, that was very difficult. I had many, many speaking engagements canceled. I had clients who wouldn't have me represent them. I can tell you that I had to work on one case pretty much behind the scenes, a case that I would have been thrilled to be in a more public role in because my opponent would have been kind of a star. It was very, very costly, and yet I would rank the OJ case as one of the most important of my career or one of the ones that had the most influence. But in terms of the challenge that was there, when I first took that case, he was facing the death penalty. And it's an interesting story. Can I take a minute just to tell